This channel, and I'm coming to you a little late because this is kind of an Easter themed shoot, but better late than never. So this is the behind the scenes, how I made my props, a little bit of a vlog on my Alice in Wonderland shoot that I did with Liam, and of course he plays the white rabbit, and he is my cute little white rabbit. He's adorable. And so you guys are gonna see how I made these cups. I know in my other channel a few people were asking about these cups, and so now you can see how I made them and watch me thrift for all the stuff for my shoot, because everything is pretty much thrifted or from the art store, and it was super cheap and inexpensive. I think the only thing I brought was the Mad Hatter hat, but it is super cheap to do these photo shoots, and I hope I give you guys some really cool ideas, whether it's just decor for your room or props for your own photo shoots. Yeah, my hair is blue. You know I can't stay one color for too long, and that orangey thing wasn't really working for me. Actually, this is probably the first video you're gonna see with my blue hair. So yay, thumbs up for blue hair. So give me a thumbs up if you love my blue hair, if you like photo shoots, and if you want to see more of this kind of stuff, let me know in the comments below. I'd really love your feedback. And if you want to see some photos from the shoots, I will have them on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, everywhere. They're gonna kind of be scattered everywhere, because who doesn't want to look at Liam in a little bunny outfit? And I'll check you out on my other channel later. I love you.
Going to Goodwill. Gonna do some thrifting for Alice in Wonderland. Whoop, whoop.
So right now I am thrifting so I can get all the stuff for the new shoot we're gonna do for Easter, kind of, but it's Alice in Wonderland inspired. So we are looking for all types of crazy looking teacups. And my baby's around here somewhere.
That works. Not really. That's ugly.
Liam.
These?
Yeah, I can use my savior found a cart. Yeah, I'll take those two.
Mommy, this isn't the cutest teacup you ever did see. I will definitely be spray painting this one.
Tough what?
And after you finish getting all your cups from Goodwill, you can spray paint them any color that you want. And for the darker cups like this one, I just use white spray paint as a base, since the dark colors show through with colored spray paint. And I do advise using spray paint as opposed to like acrylic paint, because as you can see here on this blue teapot, the paint just didn't dry right, and it kind of looks like a toddler did it. So you actually get a cleaner, even, dry color when you use spray paint. And after you finish spray painting everything, it is time to start gluing your teapots together. So just grab your E6000 glue and a few odds and ends like buttons or pearls or whatever. I have like a box of random odds and ends crafting stuff, and it actually helps a lot with stabilizing the base, so that way you can actually make it look like teacups are like tilting, and it gives it a different dimension. And it's a kind of time consuming and waiting for everything to dry and placing everything perfectly, but it's just totally worth it at the end.
Yeah, I'll break it down, I just can't take it anymore. Oh no, I won't let you go. You know I'm coming for you. No matter what it's gonna take, I gotta make this move. You're the one that I choose. You know I'm coming for you. And I just can't go another day without you next to me.
Now for the signs. This project is super easy. You can buy all this stuff at Michael's,
And then
just paint the edges of the arrows black to give the sign more dimension.
Then just cut out arrows with the colored cardstock. They don't need to be perfect because remember, this is Wonderland. Nothing is supposed to make sense, so they can be as uneven and crooked and retarded shape as possible. And remember, the arrows are supposed to be facing all different directions. So don't make the same mistake I did and ended up having everything point to the right, because that was just awkward. Then I'm gonna glue the paper down to the arrows with some paper cement glue. This glue is pretty awesome because it doesn't seep through the paper, so it's perfect for scrapbooking and anything that has to do with paper, pretty much. If I wanted to reuse these arrows for something else, I can just peel off the paper without leaving anything behind. And when the glue dries, you can actually rub off leftover glue residue, so it will never look like you overglued anything. This glue is actually pretty awesome. Then don't forget to paint your stick brown before you put your arrows on it, and you're pretty much done.
Don't have to try, I just do what I does. Don't have to tell me, I already know.